Hey, what's going on, guys? Back with another reaction, and today we're checking out Korn's brand new record, Requiem. Starting off with the second track on the album, Let the Dark Do the Rest. We've already checked out Forgotten, Start the Healing, Lost in the Grandeur earlier this week. All the singles from the album. So there's six more tracks left because it's a relatively short album, 33 minutes, only 9 songs. And all the songs are, like single radio length at in between, 3 and 4 minutes. So. I've been digging into Korn's back catalog a lot recently. Really been enjoying going through that. So, and I've also really enjoyed the singles thus far because they've it seems like they're going in a little bit of a different sonic direction, a little darker and a little more little different than what they normally do. Not doing your typical changes. But enough of my babbling. Let's get right into it. Let the dark do the rest. Kind of a classic Korn intro here, very ominous, creepy. Building it. I like that. Very interesting harmonies, like almost Alice in Chains-esque. Cool riff. Also, like the layer that Brian's adding. Oh, that's nice. Oh, you make me sick. It's cool.
Hell since it's best to conform me. Nothing's left, there is no price. Portraits of black hang inside me, quite divine. They pulse inside.
I like how they change the harmony up at the back end of the verse. Alright, sounds like about halftime here for Bridge. Well, I like those core voices. Drop back in the chorus here. Hold it out for a while. And then back in the chorus. There you go. I like that, the punch and the low growl, you make me sick there at the end. That's really cool, punching it in there like that, and having some. I actually don't think the chords themselves were interesting. I think it was the way that you had the layer that presumably Brian was laying down, and then just kind of your basic power chords that Monkey was playing in the background. But I mean, nonetheless, sonically, it builds a chord in what you're hearing. And I think that's one of the great things when, two guitar player bands do that. They don't necessarily have interesting chord voicings actually played like on the neck themselves, but once you build the two parts together, it creates something. And that's really, I think, utilizing like the full potential of what you can with your sound as a band. Really cool stuff. That feels a little more like a classic Korn track than maybe some of the other three that have been released thus far have. Not to say it's a bad thing. It's cool. I really like the song. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. Subscribe so you don't miss the other reactions to all the other Korn songs. And I'll catch you on the next one.